the teams just coming out onto the field, as you can see there. Tower Hill are in black and red stripes, very similar to the old Man City away jerseys, as we can remember from watching Man City in the past. And Burtown, very much in the traditional blue and white. Blue and white has been Burtown's colours since the club was founded many, many years ago, back in the late 1960s. So we hear League Chairman Kevin Egan, he's actually announcing the teams at the moment, and as they come onto the field, and we can see it's going to be a really good game of football, as we've said, and we'll go through the Tower Hill team as soon as Kevin has finished his announcements. And we also have Ravon Naveen coming up, and it's going to be sung live by Dom Keaton, and Dom always does a very good job at the County's Cup final in his rendition of Ravon Naveen, which is a very, very important part of all sporting events, and it's absolutely great to hear it here today in Conor Davis Park. Substitutes from Burr and Tower Hill making their way across, I suppose, going through their minds today, will they get an opportunity? Is any of them going to be the hero? Some of those guys going to maybe get themselves onto the pitch and onto the score sheet? All of that will be revealed throughout the afternoon. We talked about the injury to the Burtown player. We can see Rian hobbling across at the moment. He's coming across there on his crutches after his injury in that game against Derry Rovers. So for Tara Hill in goals, we've got Richard Downey. Number two, James Furlong. Number three is Mark Brennan. Number four, Jack Fennell. Number five, it's Aidan McGovern. Number six is Luke O'Brien. Number seven is Nathan Carpenter. Number eight is Paul Sutton. Number nine is Hayden Delaney. Number 10 is Paul Downey. Number 11, Jojo Salmon. We'll pause for Ron Naveen. So it's always good to hear Ron of Eden. Unfortunately, Dom didn't sing today, but he normally does a very good job for us. So just to complete the Tower Hill lineup, number 12, Martin Hillerit. Number 13, Brian McCormack. Number 14 is Gary Rowe. 15 is Emke Attack. 16, Kevin Phelan. 17, Shane Brophy. 18, Kevin Sheehan. Managers today for Tower Hill Rovers, PJ Garland and Paul Culloden. Physio is Paddy Kelleher, and completes the Tower Hill roundup. It's going to be a good game of football, lads. Just coming over, taking on fluids. It's a warm afternoon, it's a warm evening, so it's very, very important for players to take on their fluids, get as much into the system as they can, avoid cramp later in the match, because obviously in a warm afternoon they're going to lose a lot in terms of the moisture. So Leslie Buckley is our match official. Leslie's just having a last few instructions there with some of the Tower Hill contingent, and he's looking at the match cards, checking everything is in order. Team photograph being lined up there for Burtown, and we can see lads there getting themselves ready. And to anyone who may be familiar with Conor Davis Park, I suppose the best way to describe it is that Burr are attacking the town end for the first half with Tower Hill playing, I suppose, the Tullamore Road end of the. You can see the clubhouse in the distance as well, and that probably gives the geographics especially for people around the Midlands who are listening in, and hopefully many more people from around wherever you are in the world that you might be tuning in. We're delighted that you're actually looking in today. We hope you enjoy this game of football. So early opportunity for the Tower Hill goalkeeper to get a clearance through there, and it's going to be very, very early I suppose most players are going to take them a while to settle down and to get a feel for the game and the pace of the ball and pace of the pitch. So it's very much early days yet. Throw town to Burrtown, back to Paul Egan, their captain. Burrnock said, playing a little bit of football, trying to get a little bit of ball, get a feel for the ball, holding up good possession play as Burr build from the back. Nice play there to Declan Cahill, their commanding centre half. Good first time ball out here to the wing out, and Burrson playing good football. Pressure coming in from Tower Hill Rovers, trying to keep the, trying to put a bit of pressure on. A little bit of indecision here, and I suppose that could have been a speculative shot. Really, really good effort. Really unlucky. Really, really good effort. That was a first strike of the game coming there from Burrtown. It was from Craig Shorten, their number 8. Found the goalkeeper from Tower Hill. He was off his line. Really struck the ball very well, but just a little bit too high. So Tower Hill will be breathing a sour relief. They'll be quite happy to get out of jail from that one after a mix-up in the defence. So great kicking from the goalkeeper from Tower Hill. Get great distance on that. Won by Burrtown. I suppose the contest for the second ball is going to be vital today in terms of who picks up the second ball. And builds from the second ball is going to be really important. But again, a little bit of pressure coming back on Tower Hill as from the Burr lads, not giving them too much time to settle on the ball. And that one looks like it's gone out for a throw for Tower Hill. So very early days, very hard for lads to get settled into a big game like today. And of course, it's very different to our normal Counties Cup final, where we would have, you know, lots of support for both teams at the match. But unfortunately, due to the restrictions that are in place, and we just it's just unfortunate that supporters can't go to football, and let's hope that changes soon. Anyway, the game proceeds. Good header there, won by Burrtown centre half as he knocks it forward, and again a good contest in the middle of the field, won by Burr. Craig Short is on the ball there now. He's looking up, a little bit of time on the ball. Craig, very, very, very experienced player, has played the League of Ireland football with Athlone Town and vastly experienced, and he'll be looking to use his experience today for his home team, Burrtown. So again, Burr, probably fair to say, early exchanges in terms of possession. Only the one chance after a couple of minutes there from Craig Short, that really, I suppose, that's the only chance that we have no to talk about. So it's still 0-0. It's very, very early days. And as Tower Hill venture into the Burrtown half of the field for the first time since the game really started, they'll be looking forward to, if they'll be a little bit of hesitation there from the Burrtown number 2, Charlie Healy, but a mix up there in the defence with Tower Hill almost caused consternation, but they got away with that one. And two lads talking to each other, apologising to each other. Obviously, it's going to be important to get the communication right. Can't really, I suppose, one man calls the ball, has to go and win it. So it's a lovely afternoon for football. A bit of a wind, I suppose, favouring Burr at the moment, though. I suppose it's more diagonal. It's going to go across the field as opposed to down the field. So neither team really with too much of an advantage. So Tower Hill pick up the ball and chance for them to build from the back. So the ball is knocked out here to their left full, who is Mark Brennan. So good ball across. Danger. No. Okay. No, Burr have that well covered. Thought it was a little bit of danger beginning to develop. Good ball in there from Mark Brennan as he sought out his teammate, the number 9 for Tower Hill, who got his head on the ball. It's Hayden Delaney, but unfortunately he couldn't get it on goal and he couldn't control it. So Burr in possession of the ball at the moment now. Good win in the ball, almost a good win, a good steal there from the Tower Hill number 10, Paddy Downey. So he wins a throw for his team. Can they build on that? Can they gain possession in the corner? Good break down the corner. Unfortunately, the ball beats the end line, and a goal kick for Burrtown. So you can see the Burrtown number 2, James Furlong, has actually spread out there looking for the ball. He's thought he might take a short pass there, but the Burrtown goalkeeper, Conor Hogan, electing to go along with this particular ball and probably safe early in the day not to take any chances. So Conor strikes the ball. Good kick, moving out to the right hand side of the pitch. Good win by the Burrtown number 10 there. Ball is cleared out then again to a bit of pressure here now. Goalkeeper needs to make a clearance, and he does so. fairly safely. Good secure clearance, gets the ball to the halfway line with good pressure from Burrtown there, not letting the Tower Hill guys settle on the ball or try to build up any patterns of play. So it's very, very early days for in the County's Cup final still. So throw in comes out, it's come to Burrtown. Burrtown still playing a little bit of football at the back, as much as they can anyway. They're trying to play a bit of football. So the Borough looking up, yeah, playing the ball inside. First time ball down into Tower Hill, but that looks like it's going to be safe. Burrtown, yeah, it's gone to the Tower Hill, just playing a little bit of football in the corner. Hard to see here for me, a couple of people in my way, but Borough win, pick up possession again now. So it's with the Burrtown. Okay, cross wires there. Unfortunately, the ball fizzles out over the end line and it doesn't come to much. Cross wires there. James Furlong was trying to reach, knock the ball inside to the Burrtown number then, David McAvoy, but didn't get the run right, didn't get the communication right. So it ends up with a goal kick to Tower Hill Rovers. So it's not much gone in the game. If I can manage to... We can actually see the ball is cleared out. Yeah, it's a free header there for Paul Egan in the middle of the park. But 6 minutes gone in the match so far, so it is very early days. So, good win again there by David McAvoy for Burrtown. Good clearance there. Of course, you can see the wind there catching that ball. Very hard to judge it for a defender. Very important to get the calls right. The keeper picked up the ball, so safely in the hands of Richard Downey. But wind playing a little bit of a part there. You can see the way it caught up the ball, it held it up. Very difficult to judge it when, of course, when that happens. But in the main, it's a good game. It's a good day for football. And a bit of a tussle in the midfield. Good win by the Tower Hill number 10 there. He won that ball well for his team. Ball has been spread out wide there. Again, the step on the ball, hold it up. Good play by Tower Hill there. Trying to hold a bit of possession. Trying to build a bit. Borough pressing them hard now. Starting to come in again. So again, here we have... Tower Hill in possession, knocking the ball wide, trying to hold up the possession. Good release, or almost a good release there from the Tower Hill number 2 into on the inside. But Borough pick up the ball in the middle of the field. Very well spread wide into this space. And an underhit pass there, unfortunately, means the tack fizzles out. Tower Hill build up play now. It's getting a little bit more frenetic as the game now. They've started to get a little bit of gas into the tank, get their second win together, some of the players. So some good football players. And man, almost caught in possession here. Tower Hill skipper there, number 6, was almost caught by Luke O'Brien, but he managed to avert the danger there and clear the ball. So Tower Hill now, first time in the game that Tower Hill have got a couple of passes together, and it's good to see that. Good to see the link of play threatened for the first time. Again, it favours the Burrtown number 4, who was caught a little bit late. Ray Cordial there cleared these lines and caught a little bit late afterwards by the Tower Hill number 9. No complaints. Hayden Delaney, he acknowledges the free and chance for Burr to get their shape back and launch an attack via their goalkeeper, Conor Hogan. Neither goalkeeper forced into any save yet. Only opportunity of the match that has come so far via a well-placed lob by Greg Shorty, almost caught the Tower Hill goalkeeper off the line. That was after a couple of minutes. Since then, really has been pretty much even Stevens, maybe for shading the possession just a little bit, as it's very, very early days. So anyone tuning in, it's 0-0, no score in the match. It's the 19-20 John Farrell Wine Counties Cup final, and it's Burrtown versus Tower Hill. A little bit of an underhand pass there by the number 2, Charlie Hurley from Burrtown. But Charlie done okay. He got his team out of jail. Charlie, of course, is from Forban, but playing with Burr, and playing in the senior division with Burrtown and enjoying his football. I was talking to his mum after the semi final win last week. Two semi finals played last week. Tower Hill, pretty emphatic win against Temple Villa on a 3-0 scoreline. Burr made very hard by Mount Melick. Mount Melick hosting this cup final today. And as you can see, it were made work very, very hard. It finished 2-1, but only after in the second half, Mount Melick took a 1-0 lead, a deserved 1-0 lead. Had a couple of chances possibly to increase their lead and to win, push on in the match. Unfortunately, and as we know in football, if you miss those chances, they'll always come back to roost. And Burr got back into the game and deservedly just about went on to win it. So here we are, it's with Tower Hill, it's at the back. They're looking around for a little bit of space. It's very, very tight, of course, and both teams trying to find that little bit of space and a little bit of room. It's at a premium at the moment, so Craig Short's on the ball there. He's looking, he's held it up. It's good play, he's knocked it inside to the Bull Town centre half there, number nine. Got caught in possession, and it looks like Tower Hill are going to clear, so good defending there from Tower Hill in that particular occasion. Really was, and their number 10 is certainly Paddy Downey's a couple of really important touches in the game, and done very well to rob the ball that time then from the board down number 9, Nicky Malloy. So it's 7-8 minutes gone in the match, so ball knocked out wide here to the Tower Hill player. So Tower Hill holding the ball up well, they're playing some nice football. They're ball over the top, good ball looking to their centre forward. He has the ball, he's managed to hold onto the ball there, and he's looking for support from somebody. Maybe he's trying to turn, see can he get across, and he does, but it's straight into the arms of the goalkeeper, Bortown. Really good bit of football there. Nice ball knocked over the top and well picked up by Hayden. Hayden Delaney, and unfortunately his shot didn't really trouble Bor, so ball is cleared down again. It's Tower Hill have settled, got into the game a little bit more in the last couple of minutes there. Referee did see the pull there. I think we all saw that, and can't be any complaints there, as it was Nathan Williams who actually pulled the Bortown player back, and referee didn't miss that one. Leslie Buckley, very, very experienced official, so Leslie is never going to miss that particular incident there. And so well done to Leslie on spotting that particular one. So Bor building up, they have a ball knocked out wide here to the number 10, and ball is knocked in again and cleared. Didn't beat the first defender, so it didn't really trouble. Did a Tower Hill, a ball knocked in, it's speculative. It's good defending there by the number 4 from Tower Hill. And again, some good football here, some neat hitting control play. Craig Short beats his man, knocks it inside. Yeah, referee did see it. Bor Town number 12, or the Martin Hiller there, actually not happy with the decision. He doesn't believe it was a free kick, so Leslie Buckley, the official, is going to take the opportunity to actually have a word with Martin, just a quiet word, say, let's settle down. I made the decision, my decision, I'm going to call it. So, ball is going to be swung in here by the Bor Town number 11, who is Nathan Williams. So, can he actually get this ball in? Can he put pressure on with this ball? A lot of Declan Cahill, big man up from the back. Ball swung in. It looks keeper's ball. Yeah, good call from the goalkeeper. Too near him, I suppose. It was fair to say he was always going to win that ball. It's good curl on the ball, but not the right trajectory. So goalkeeper cleared it. Now, with the Bor Town defence out, the chance here, is this going to be the first scoring chance for Tower Hill? They had a chance. Oh, he fluffed it. He'd done all the approach work. Good ball in. Bor were still recovering from the corner kicks. Quick break down the field. Nathan done all the... controlled the ball well, got himself into position. Unfortunately, couldn't get any venom behind the shot, but it's encouraging signs for Tower Hill. I'm sure they'll be delighted with that. That's their first strike. It's the first time that Conor Hogan's had to make a save, and so that is, from that point of view, I suppose they're going to be encouraged, and they're going to say to themselves, look, you know, we're in this game, we've had an opportunity, Bor have had an opportunity. So the only two opportunities really that have come to either team at this stage of the game, the first one after a couple of minutes from Bor Town, and that particular one coming after 13 minutes. So 13 minutes gone in this particular cup final here in Conor Davis Park in Mount Mellick. And we want to thank Mount Mellick as well for staging the final for us. The place looks absolutely resplendent. Great work been completed by the Mount Mellick committee to try and get the venue as good as it is. It really has come on in leaps and bounds over the last couple of years. So Bor on the attack here, ball over the top, but dealt with quite well by Jack Fennell at the back. Jack, big, tall, strong player, and he's going to be very commanding in the air, so Bor are going to have to work hard to beat Jack, particularly in the air. If the ball's into the air, you're going to have to say that Jack is very commanding presence, so he's going to have an opportunity to sweep up anything that comes in high. So Bor will certainly have to work, you know, to think of plan B instead of maybe the ball being across. So Paul Egan knocks the ball, finds a good ball there to Craig Short. Some fine, nice pocket of space. Gray, and he has a shot. Not a bad opportunity. Good save by the goalkeeper. It might have been going wide, but very, very good save there from Richard Downey in the Tower Hill. He didn't know, I suppose, it was going wide. He had to make a decision, and he got the ball. He beat it away very well. So That's after 15, is it 15 minutes gone in the match? No, 14 minutes gone, so second little bit of a striker opportunity coming up there in the game for Burr, courtesy of Craig Shorten. Good strike and goal, and good save by the Tower Hill goalkeeper. So Burr now starting to knock the ball around very well again. Ball over the top, but don't think this is, it looks like it's going to run out of play. Yeah, it did. It's gone out of play. It was always difficult for the Burr Town number 11 to try and pick up that one. Nathan Williams, he was under a bit of pressure. Ball was a long bit away too far. Ball up the line. Well, I suppose, challenged by Burr. Burr have won the ball back now. Ball is back with Burr Town. A little bit of intricate play again between the Burr players. Ball is knocked out wide here to Declan Cahill. Declan, big strong centre half as well. He's looking round. Ball over the top. Nice ball. Linesman's flag has gone up though. Unfortunately, he was a little bit ahead of the play, but again, you can see Declan Cahill building from the back, ball over the top, and so Burr are mixing their game very well. They've a couple of intricate passing movements in the midfield when they have the space and they have the opportunity, but not afraid to go along as well and put a little bit of pressure on the back from Tower Hill through direct football. So Tower Hill have the possession of the ball now. They're looking for a bit of space. Good ball out here to the number three. His first time ball, unfortunately, and he got back. Good recovery there from the Tower Hill number three. Yeah, he done very well to get it there. Good interception there from Burr as well. So really, both teams showing of great hunger here now. Burr Town number nine has the ball. He just looks inside. Oh, good recovery there from Martin Hillard. Very good recovery. Martin, vastly experienced. He's 38 years of age now. Martin has been a long time around playing football as well, and I'm sure he's really looking forward to today's game as well. So here we have got Craig Short. Now he's on the ball. Craig is vastly experienced Burr player, as we've said already. Nice ball inside there to his teammate and midfielder. Unfortunately, losing out there, Burr, but it's back in possession of the play, back in ball. So here we have Burr again. It's some nice play, but didn't beat the first man. And Burr knocking the ball. So Paul Egan, Paul is on the ball. He's driving forward and knocks it wide to his teammate. Ball has been played around very, very nicely between Burr at the moment. Can they get an end result? No, they can't really. Ball breaks down. So instead of finding a team man, unfortunately he falls to Tower Hill player, and to get the chance to clear the lines. Nice, not afraid to play the ball out from the back. It's really good to see that. Holding the ball up and knocking the ball around, trying to find their men with the ball, with the passes. So really good play from Tower Hill here. They've took this thing out of the game. The Burr lads, I suppose, had to retreat. So in this particular occasion, the pressure couldn't really play. So struggling to get it a little bit beyond midfield, though, Tower Hill. They really will need to do something there. And the referee there deemed that Craig's Short's challenge on Martin Hillard was a little bit late. And in fairness to Leslie, he's just having a quiet word. And as we know, that's the sensible thing to do. In early days, good game of football so far. Both teams trying to play football the right way. Both teams intent on getting on with things and in the right way. So we've got, it's the anyone tuning in. It's 0-0 in this particular game. 18 minutes played in the 19-20 John Fyle Kyle County's Cup final between Burr Town and Tower Hill. And if anyone missed the start, just looking there, Luke O'Brien breaks the ball down. He knocks it out wide. Is this a chance to get the ball in? No, well snuffed out by the Burr Town defence. But again, encouraging signs for Tower Hill. They're well in this game. Burr are favourites by virtue of the fact that they have won their senior division last week. 2 weeks ago, they won the senior division title. Won it last week, of course, they were playing in the County's Cup semi-final, but going for a really a unique double, I suppose. It's been done a couple of times by teams in the CCFL, the County's Cup and the league, for trying to join that particular group of people who've done it in the past. Ball knocked in the bin. Oh, what a chance. Oh, what a score from Nathan. It wasn't actually, it was, yeah, it was Joe Salmon, brilliant, finishing by Jojo. Hesitancy in the Burr Town defence, ball had come across from the box, and Jojo latched onto it, took it, mistake, it was Burr Town number two who was kind of caught a little bit ball napping, and unfortunately for him, but fortunately for Jojo Salmon, ball hit the back of the net. Jojo, lethal with his finish. About 8 yards out, very centred. Unfortunately, the Burr Town keeper, Conor Hogan, had no opportunity with that particular one. So, very bright start of the game. So Tower Hill won up, and that game, courtesy of that goal, came in the 19th minute of the match. 19 minutes gone. Bird Town 0, Tower Hill Rovers 1. Joe Salmon scoring that goal in the 19th minute. So well done. Bird Town went behind. They won't panic. They went behind last week against Monmouth in the second half of the match, but they really upped their game after that, and managed to close out the win against Monmouth. So they're not going to be panicked, but Tower Hill will be hugely encouraged. Of course, they are the underdogs, and they will be hugely encouraged courtesy of that particular strike. Great strike by Jojo Salmon. And so is it this going to be Tower Hill's day? Is it going to be the day that the Division 1 team get their name on the County's Cup for the first time? Burr, who have won the County's Cup 3 times in the past, they're going for their 4th title, last one 2 years ago. They've had a very, very successful couple of years, Burr Town. They would have been favourites going into the match today, but as we know, Cup Finals, anything can happen. So good play, good strong play by the number 5 there, Aidan McGovern for Tower Hill, holding the ball up, doing very well from a defensive point of view for his team, forcing the Burr Town number 9, Nicky Malloy, into the foul, and Tower Hill get the opportunity to clear their lines. So very warm day. You can see that players are already struggling a little bit with the heat. Jojo Salmon, the only goal scorer of the game, little knock back there, to finds his man. He certainly has a good touch. He's looking there, good ball inside. Yeah, it's found into Nathan Delaney. Stepped on the ball, the number 10 stepped on the ball. It was an accident there. He is going to give a free this time though, because there was a foul. The second one was definitely a foul. The first one, I think Leslie got it right. The Tower Hill player stepped on the ball and Paddy Downey, but the second one was definitely a foul from Ray Cordial on the Tower Hill number 9. So it's a long way out. It's Burr Town, or it's the Tower Hill number 7, who is Nathan Carpenter. Nathan lining up the shot. It seems to be, he's about 24 yards out. Is he going to have a goal? Is he going to dink it in over the top? Hope that he can find some of his players. Burr have the 4-man wall. He's going to have a shot. He tries a curler. It's too high and too wide, so not really troubling the Burr Town keeper, Conor Hogan. So here we are. Anyone joining us? It's Burr Town 0. It's Tower Hill 1. It's 22 minutes gone in the final in this match, and it's the final of the 2019-20 John Farrell Combined Counties Cup. So Burr Town with possession of the ball at the moment. Burr playing in the traditional blue and white, and Tower Hill playing in the black and red striped outfit. So Burr holding up the possession, trying to keep pressure on the Burr Town, not let them settle into their play. So Martin Hillard on the ball at the moment there, finds his man. Another ball that's gone wide, loses possession of the ball there. So good ball into Nicky Malloy, nearly got a turn on his man, but again, good defensive play there by the Tower Hill number 4. So Joe Salmon on the ball at the moment now. Tower Hill are not afraid to hang on to the ball. You can see that the way they're finding the man, finding possession, playing very, very well. And then in situations like this, big long ball, Joe is in. It's 2-0 up. Oh, can you believe that? Big long ball over the top. Brilliant ball. An assist by Jack Fennell. Great ball in over the top. Jojo Salmon got onto the end of the ball. Consternation in the defence. And he managed to get to the ball before the Burr Town goalkeeper, Scott Hogan. So this is really, really exciting for Tower Hill. 23 minutes gone in the match, and it's Burr Town 0, Tower Hill Rovers 2. Really, really exciting. If you're a Tower Hill supporter or if you're a Tower Hill player, they really are going to be excited. So the second goal there, two goals in 4 minutes, 5 minutes, have given Tower Hill a commanding position in this particular game. But they really have got the bit between their teeth at this stage. Fair to say that they're really contesting all the ball. They're getting the break, they're getting the second ball. We talked about the second ball and how important it was, and they've certainly managed to actually outsmart Burr Town so far in the match. Burr, we've talked about it, have been behind before, they are not going to be afraid. They're not going to be afraid. They know they would get their way back into the match. They've got the players, they've got the experience, but Tower Hill are really, really up for this match. You can see it. They're trying to get first to the ball. And that's referee Leslie Buckley deeming that particular movement there between the centre half and Declan Cahill and Nathan Delaney. Nathan pushed the centre half, so Leslie gave the free kick. So here we go. Burr start to build from the back again. Ball in there to their number two. He tries a bit of and a late challenge there, seen by both Leslie and his official. Foul for Mark Brennan. He caught the Burr Town player. It's the first yellow card in the match. Couldn't quite see myself, but Leslie is usually pretty good when he sees those situations. So first yellow card in the match, and it's come there at 25 minutes. So it's a yellow card there for Mark Brennan. So he has to watch himself for the rest of the match. Mark there, so he's on a yellow. He caught David McAvoy late, and the referee issued a yellow card. So Craig Short now going to try and knock the ball into the box, see can he get supports on it. Oh, almost deflected goalwards there off the foot of Nicky Malloy from that cross by Craig Short. But Jojo Salmon there, good link up play there with Nathan as well. Certainly Tower Hill up front are causing the Burr Town defence. Jojo Salmon with the two goals, he certainly seems to have the measure of the Burr Town defence, and Nathan Delaney causing consternation as well. Big physical player, he's causing problems. Good ball across the field there from Burr, but unfortunately, while the number 11 got it under control, he could only present it to Tower Hill fullback, who knocked it out. So Burr now in an attacking position. They certainly will need to try and get themselves back into this game if they can before half time. It's 2-0. Tower Hill, the underdogs, lead in this particular game. It's really, really a good game of football, and it's one that, from a spectator's point of view, a very enjoyable game of football. And I suppose it's fair to say there might be a shock on the cards here. It's early days. We're not going to say that this game is over by any means. 2-0. It's a huge challenge for Burr to get back in the game, but it's not insurmountable. A little bit of confusion there between the two. Tower of Fields giving a shot coming in from them. Yeah, and a free handball. It was a handball. So we could see the number 12, Martin Hillard, remonstrating with Leslie, but Leslie has deemed it to be a free, and certainly looks like a very good opportunity here for Burr, about 21 yards out from goal. They're in fairly central position. Nicky Malloy standing over the ball, as is Craig Short, having a chat. They're trying to make a decision in relation to who is maybe going to take a strike. Ball is held up a little bit. At the moment, one of the Burr Tower Hill players looking for possession. He's looking for a little bit of attention, so we can see that Leslie has called on. It looks like the number 6, Luke O'Brien, who's down to captain from Tower Hill. There's 28 minutes gone in the match, and it's 2-0. Anyone tuning in late, or anybody coming to join the stream late, Striker Online, and we're really very appreciative of Striker Online for streaming this match, and some great games of football over the last couple of weeks from Striker Online and by Eamon and his team. Great to see grassroots football being, I suppose, getting an opportunity to get out there on the social media platforms the way it's been done. So the free kick coming up now. So the lads have had their discussion about where it's going. Looks like Craig Short's making the run up. It looks like it. And Nicky Malloy's had a shot on it. It's off the number. It was straight into the back of the Tower Hill number 4. Who doesn't mind? He'll take that. From his perspective, he's going to be quite happy that he'll take it back like that. He'll take one for the team at 2-0. It's real upset here on the cards if the game remains this way. So good kick out from the Burr Town goalkeeper there as he finds his man. Nice ball in over the top. Bit of confusion. Nobody coming in there to capitalise on that. Bit of confusion. If Burr managed to get the next game, it's game on again. if Tower Hill get another one, you would imagine it's going to be really hard for Burr to get back in. Almost an opportunity there in the game. Burr's best two chances in the game have come from Craig Short, who had a two-minute shot and also a shot on the 13th minute, which troubled the Tower Hill goalkeeper. Other than that, it's been Tower Hill who've been lethal with the presented chances that they've been opportunity. So Luke O'Brien is on the binder. Lucas, good footwork by Luke to get himself out of trouble. So Jojo couldn't get the ball there, Jojo Salmon for Tower Hill. He couldn't get that one under the trace, so Burr Town are going to resume with a throw-in back to Declan Cahill, their centre-half, and he knocks the ball out to his co-partner Ray Cordial. Ray knocks the ball down the line, so Burr start to build from the back again, as they have done. Ball inside to Declan, to Paul Egan. So Paul is looking for a good ball over the top, just a little bit too far for Craig Short, just a little bit short. So Paul Egan, the Burr Town captain, a little bit unlucky there. He almost linked up with Craig Short as Ray made a run in from the midfield area. So here we have the good contest again, we'll see. Referee deemed that to be a foul. It certainly is a great contest there between Declan Cahill and Hayden Delaney, the number nine for Tower Hill. It really is a very, very good contest there. Every time they go in, they're two physical players. They're putting themselves about, and they really are giving it their best now. So, attacking position here in the game for Tower Hill now is the launch from this other half. Good ball in. Good ball in the end, but Burr managed to clear their lines. And again, a mistake there gives chance to Burr to break. So, Paddy Downey had got back there fairly well, and he got himself back in position and got himself wide to take the ball wide, launches the ball down the line, down to their number seven. He knocks the ball across to Declan Cahill. Declan, cool there, managed to control the ball and clear his lines. Martin Hillard knocks the ball down to Jojo Salmon, two goal hero so far, two goals for Jojo for his team as they lead this game by 2-0. Martin Hillard, he got caught in position there by Craig Short. Good recovery there, really good recovery. Good football, but the referee had deemed that to be a little bit late. So he's having a word with Martin there now, and he's just telling the guys to slow it down a little bit. 32 minutes gone in the first half of the 19-20 Combined Counties Cup Final. Anyone joining in or anybody looking in, it's Burr Town 0, Tower Hill Rovers 2. Two goals courtesy of Jojo Salmon. First goal in the 19th minute, the second goal in the 23rd minute. And two opportunist goals, well taken by Jojo, giving his team a lead. So ball knocked in, big ball into the back. Declan Cahill got on it. Yeah, it came. It came off Declan. Declan got to the ball first, and it came off the back of Jack Fennell, the Tower Hill number four, out for a corner kick. So Paul Egan, the Burr Town captain, makes his way out, and he's gone out to take that corner kick. So he's lining up, wind going across the pitch, sort of changed a little direction. It was diagonal at one stage, ball is in. Is there an opportunity here for someone to get a good clearance by Fennell there, towering above everybody, and the goalkeeper comes out, gets two-faced, good clearance, and that's completed then as Burr Town. As Burr Town, I suppose, weren't going to take any chances. The number three, Keith McAvoy, the option was to get the ball out as quickly as possible, and he did that. So wasn't going to take any chances because they were stretched at the back, and both centre-halves had gone forward for the corner kick. They weren't back in position. So as anyone will ever tell you, when you're the opinion, you take safety first, you don't get caught. His team were 2-0 down. He certainly doesn't want to go 3-0 down before half-time. Shane Corby, their manager, is going to have a lot of work to do to talk to his lads at half-time to try and get them back into this game, because they have a huge mountain to climb to get back in the match. So Burr start building from the back. So Jojo Salmon working very hard to try and split the players as Burr knocked the ball around at the back, but Tower Hill making them work. So Paul Egan picks the ball up, knocks the ball out wide again here to Charlie Healy. He knocks the ball back inside to Clare Shark. So certainly Burr and Craig Short doing very, very well. Good ball across. So Burr working hard to get space, to get position. But then they go and spoil it all when the number three, Keith McAvoy, unfortunately loses possession. The ball goes out for a Tower Hill throw. But Tower Hill having to work very hard. But again, the two guys up front for Tower Hill, Hayden Delaney and Jojo Salmon, working very, very hard for the team and really causing a lot of problems for the Boroughtown defence. And even support working off the ball as much as when the ball comes in. So the ball is knocked across. Declan Cahill gets down, heads the ball out, finds his number four, Ray Cardell, and Bord managed to clear. So ball broke into the middle of field. Martin Hillard is on the ball. Martin, lovely step over, knocks out. Huge experience there with Martin Hillard. You can see how he has years of experience, finds the man in space. So unfortunately for Tower Hill to lose possession, Boroughtown pick up. Paul Egan there, good play from Boroughtown, but I think Bord need to try and keep passing the ball a little bit quicker, get out of the fence, create some chances for their team. But so here we have Bord again starting to build up from the back. It's Ray Cordial. He'll look up, he looks inside, and it's Paul Egan. His man is on, so knocks the ball back to Declan Cahill. Bord keeping very good shape with their players wide, trying to stretch the play, trying to stretch the game. So ball kept going. So it's Declan Cahill has gone forward, and he had managed to keep falling. So this is where I think Craig Short robs the ball from Joe Salmon there. He has the ball, tries to thread it through, but again, Tower Hill snuff out the danger, then make a mistake when they had the possession. Boroughtown number seven almost breaks through there, but Paddy Downey now makes the ball quickly. Great ball up to him, but just unfortunately overhits the ball for Nathan Carter. But really good, smart play there from Paddy Downey. Craig Short picks up the ball. Good frenetic play. It's really good cup-type football now at this stage. Good step over from Paul Egan there as he swivels inside. Knocks the ball inside. Is this an opportunity? It is. The number 11 has gone through. Oh, good save from the Tower Hill goalkeeper. Good bit of play there from Boroughtown. Paul Egan, Nathan linking up very well with Nathan Williams. Nathan got around the goalkeeper, but he's a big man as Richard Downey in the Tower Hill goals, and he spread himself well and made the save. So, again, no clear header of the winner, but good experience play. Ray Cordial there knocks it back to his goalkeeper, and the goalkeeper rolls the ball out there to Ray after, as Burr, once again the pattern is clear. They're starting to build, they're trying to build. You can hear their manager Shane Corby to keep it to feet, keep it on the ground. He's issuing the instructions, but Tower Hill are certainly so far packing out the defence and closing down the spaces very well, so really not giving Burr much of a chance. Burr have a big challenge now, 2-0 down, so good ball inside, but Luke O'Brien, the captain, intercepting that ball through. So Tower Hill again break out. They hold up, they're looking for possession. They're certainly playing this game very well. Great ball down the line to their number 10, Paddy Town, but he's a little bit isolated at the moment. He's holding the ball up though. He's not afraid to have a run at it. Almost get around, but Ray Cordial done very well. He held the ball up. He was very isolated. The only support he had at the time was Nathan Carpenter, and he decided to hold on to the ball and knock it through. So Aidan Delaney was the only one he had up in support, so he couldn't find it, but he won himself a corner kick. And we can see that Nathan Carpenter is making his way out nice and slowly. He's not going to be in a rush. We'll just do a chime check for everybody. 37 minutes gone in the first half, so bit to go to the break. Good ball across, good header there from Jack Fennell, but he couldn't get any power behind it, but he just won the header. Good ball, quick ball down. So this is an opportunity for the Boroughtown number 11. Almost got it, almost. So, well done, though. Richard Downey, he recovered very well. Richard there, he ball, very, very quick ball down. And it was the Boroughtown number 11 who was challenging for the ball, Nathan Williams. He couldn't get his foot on it and snuffed out the danger there, Richard Downey. So, here we go, big ball launch forward. Second ball being picked up by Bird through Keith McAvoy. So, Keith is on the ball now. He's looking around, looking for a bit of support. Plays it off the Tower Hill player, and it goes out just on the halfway line. He has a throw in, trying to launch Bord into an attacking part of the field. So Paul Egan, Boroughtown captain, picks up the ball, knocks it back to Declan Cahill. And we can see where Bord are starting to build up. But Tower Hill certainly happy to concede the space to them, happy to do that, and then hit them on the break like they did. Like now, you can see that particular passage of play where Nathan Delaney try to help his team, but ball now with Boroughtown knocking it about. So Bord still trying to probe and find those spaces of pockets of space, but it's very, very tight because it's a packed defence, picked up here at the back by Jack Fennell. And we know Jack is not going to do it, and silly launches that ball forward, only finds Ray Cordial though. Ray traps the ball, picks it up, and again Bord knocking it around. So very much last 10 minutes of the match, like we've had those two great opportunities put away by Tower Hill, but Bord now most of the possession, most of the play, but not really troubling the Tower Hill Rovers. They're just lacking a little bit of incision when it comes to the final third of the field. So we've got Craig Short now, and he's looking around, and you can see how Tower Hill have packed the defence, and it's very hard to find space. Really is very hard to find space. And Tower Hill are not going to be too anxious to give up any space. Or so Craig is on a little bit of a drive there now. Yeah, knocks it out wide to Keith McAvoy up from the full-back position. Back to Ray Cordell. Nearly all the play, you can see nearly all the players, all bar two players now in the Tower Hill half of the pitch. And then a silly ball just gives the ball away. And it's a one ball, and a goalkeeper from Burr comes out off his line. He was well out of his bit, but had to get that right, because if he hadn't, it looked like the Tower Hill player, Hayden Delaney, was in. So good goalkeeping by Conor Hogan from Burr. Had to make the clearance because Burr were very, very stretched at the back. They were caught wide open. So very much a pattern of play here now, where Burr are playing the ball out, playing the football, trying to get probe for spaces. But Tower Hill, when they get the opportunity to break fast, and they are causing problems. So Tower Hill in possession of the ball at the moment. Happy to knock the ball back. Happy to concede the space, because they want to build from the back, and then they will do like that, put a good ball through, or try and find the two front men who were causing all the problems. So here we go now, Burr on the attack, but losing possession of the ball. And Leslie Buckley there, match official, has given a free kick there for, and excuse the expletives there if anybody's listening or picked up anything in the background. As we know, sometimes our passions get away with ourselves in football, and these things happen. But anyway, so we have free kick for Burr coming up now. At this stage, it's can't quite see with the sun, is actually making it hard for me to see how much is left in the game. It's about 4 minutes to half time, so 41 minutes gone in the first half of the match. And it's a very promising position here for Burr Town, as Craig Short looks like he's over the ball. The back, every player except the Burr Town number two, ball is lobbed in, and it's a very poor delivery. And now Tower Hill will actually have a chance to break. Ball is knocked out wide. It's not a great ball. It's going to beat everybody. But that particular passage of play, everybody except Charlie Healy were in the Tower Hill half of the field. So it just goes to show the pressure that Burr have now started to exert. But Tower Hill won't mind that pressure, because they are certainly coping with it so well at this stage. So here we go. Burr Town knocking around the ball again. So into Paul Egan. Miscontrols the ball. And he does get the free kick. Yeah, a good play there from Paddy Downey. He nipped in, and Paul Egan just miscontrolled it. That's football at this level. If you don't, it's almost instant control. You nearly have to take possession of the ball in a clean stride, because if you don't, the Tower Hill fellas are chomping at the bit to try and get in to unsettle the Burr lads. Really fascinating game of football. 42 minutes gone in the first half. It's Burr Town 0, Tower Hill Rovers 2. The two goals for Tower Hill coming in the 19th and 23rd minute by Jojo Salmon, who is having a very, very good game of football. Clinical, but he's finished. And now it's a free kick out there, and I think that was deemed as a foot high by number 3 from Tower Hill, who had the foot up. So dangerous play was the award there. So bad mistake here, or a free kick, and almost Burr played themselves into trouble. So we've got Paddy Downey on the ball. He looks up now, he finds his captain Luke O'Brien, and that ball comes off the referee, so it has to be hopped, and it's given back to Martin Hillard. So he has the ball. Martin looked up, he didn't know what to do, so Martin has the ball now. He has a shot, but Conor Hogan got behind the ball, and Conor Hogan got behind that one there, snuffed it out. It was a good effort from Martin Hillard. He did very well to actually get the shot away, and picked up a knock for his troubles then in the as he followed through. I think one of the Burr fellas came through as he was trying to challenge for the ball and might have caught Martin. So Martin, a very experienced player, was talking to Paddy Kelleher, the secretary from Tower Hill. Paddy's been working so hard for his club over the years, and I'm sure he must be really, really excited at this moment in time with the proceedings and the way things have gone. So Leslie is actually calling in the physio. There will be a bit of stoppage time here in the match, because there has been a couple of stoppages in the match, and so from that point of view, it's now 44 minutes gone into first half. But I will say that there will be, the second time there has been a physio on, so there will be some stoppage time to be played before the end of the match. Sun is shining here, it's very warm in the break here now. It looks like that they're players are trying to take some fluid on board. Anybody listening, looking one eye on the Premiership, one score coming to hand. It's West Brom 0, Leicester 3 in that particular game. I'm not sure how much is played in it. It's just a result that it's a scoreline I see coming up here in the Premier League. The newly promoted teams in the Premier League not faring too well, but this particular situation here is the Counties Cup final. It's the 2019-20 playing of the Counties Cup final, and it's Burrtown 0, Tower Hill 2. Ball launched forward by Burr, managed to get the ball, so Charlie Hurley has the ball. He plays a good 1-2 there with Burrtown, but snuffed out by Burr. Martin Hillard intercepted, so Burr win the ball, get it back. Billet to and from, a hike forward, I suppose you could call it, from the Burrtown centre forward. Their number 11 has the ball, he looks up the side. It really didn't trouble, it was always going to be too high, and with that, it's referee Leslie Buckley blows it up in what has been a really, really entertaining first half of football here. It's the Counties Cup final, and it's at half time. Scoreline of Burrtown 0, Tower Hill 2. So we'll be back for the second half. Enjoy your half time cup, and we'll talk to you again very, very soon. Okay, welcome back everybody to Conor Davis Park, the 2019-2020 Counties Cup final. It's half time, and at the moment it's Tower Hill 2, Burrtown 0, as we wait for the start of the second half. Thankfully, it's a wonderful setting, wonderful weather as well for the Counties Cup final. And as we said at the start of the match, so unusual to have a Counties Cup final being played. It's never happened this way before. It's very unlikely it'll happen this way again. We don't know. I suppose this, with COVID and the way things have happened over time, it's really, really hard to tell if this will happen again in the future. But at the moment, anyway, it's a super game of football. Intriguing stuff, because the underdogs, Tower Hill, lead this match by 2-0. Two goals coming in the first half, 19th minute and the 23rd minute. Two goals by currently their hero, anyway, Jojo Salmon. But a good team performance. And certainly it's going to make him for a second, very, very busy second half. So first of all, the substitution been made. Burrtown number 13 is on, and he is replacing the Burrtown number 10, who is David McAvoy. So first change in the match, I suppose, a 2-0 down. Burrtown manager Shane Corby trying to make something happen, or get something different in his team, or it could have been a knock, because generally speaking, we know managers don't normally make changes at half time if they can avoid it, and they normally like to wait and see. This game could go to extra time and penalties, but we'll just have to wait and see. So Burr start the game launching the attack. They really probably need to get back in something. An unfortunate stumble there by the Burrtown fullback. He fell, unfortunately, but Paul Egan picked it up, Burrtown captain. Burr now have really going to have to start strongly in the second half if they want to get back in the match. Good ball across the ball, and it's fallen to the Burrtown player, almost in. Oh, the number 13 for Burrtown, almost getting in there. That's Burrtown substitute is Stephen Hanrahan. Stephen is on for number 10, David McAvoy, halftime substitute, and almost proven with the first kick, his first kick of this second half, and his first kick of the game. He almost got in for one. And Tower Hill will be lucky, or feel that they've lucky that they've weathered that particular storm. And the game remains at 2-0 to Tower Hill. Again, just anyone that might have joined our Striker Online service a little bit later, anyone here, certainly locally, people will know that Tower Hill are playing into the town end as they play from left to right, and Burrtown attacking the Tullamore end of the goal. And referee gives a free kick there for a foul. Martin Hillard fouled one of the Burrtown players there, and match assistant Leslie is actually just saying to the number 12 for Tower Hill, Martin Hillard, that's it, no more. He doesn't want to see that happening. So it's early in the second half, 2 minutes gone in the second half. Of Burtown launched the ball in, it comes in, it's a good ball, it's going to be held up in the wind. It's a good, good contest between Declan Cahill and Jack Fennell, two big men. Declan Cahill won the ball, and the ball launched quickly forward now, and a bit of indecision again, and it was almost Hayden Delaney getting in there between the Burtown Ray Cordial centre half and the goalkeeper Conor Hogan. Has a little bit of hesitation there, so again we have a little bit of a hold up play here. Martin Hillard has gone down, taking a little bit of a knock, and match official just checking in there to see if everything is okay, and he's moved on, and he's having a quiet word with the Tower Hill captain Luke O'Brien, explaining whatever decision or whatever the query was, and has done his business, Leslie has, and is moving on. So Tower Hill with a chance to launch the ball forward just inside the Burtown half of the pitch, and they're hitting this ball. It's a good ball, it's held up, it's holding up in the air, it's aimed towards Jack Fennell, the big man. He does win the ball and he gets the head on it, directs the header, but it's sails harmlessly wide. Couldn't really get any direction on the header because it held up too long, but nonetheless, from a Tower Hill perspective, they're happy to see where the ball actually is now. So Scott Hogan looking to seek any, or Conor Hogan seeking to take the ball quickly. He manages to find Ray Cordial, so he's looking for the ball short and he gives it inside. So Burr are actually under a bit of pressure and a little bit of a break and play here as the Tower Hill goalkeeper, or number six, I think it is number six, Luke O'Brien, the captain who's gone down. It took a bit of a knock there. Referee didn't give a foul, he didn't see anything in it. I think it was probably a 50-50 challenge, and as he attempted to go in, and the Burr player managed to get the ball away, and Luke O'Brien picked up a bit of a knock for his troubles. I think hopefully Luke will be okay. He's physio stretching and moving around there, but we can roughly go through the Burtown team if we have a chance before the resuming play. In goals is number one, Conor Hogan, number two, Charlie Healy, number three, Keith McAvoy, number four is Ray Cordial, number five, Declan Cahan, number six, Paul Egan, their captain, Dean Cahill is number seven, number eight is Craig Short, number nine is Mickey Malloy, number 11 is Nathan Williams, and their sub who has come on in the second half is number 13, Stephen Hanrahan. In a moment or two, I will give you the Tower Hill lineup. Just about approaching 4 minutes of the second half, as the referee hops the ball and he knocks it back. So Tower Hill Rovers are in goals. Richard Downey, number two. James Furlong, number three, is Mark Brennan. Mark on the early yellow card from early in the first half. Number four is Jack Fennell. Number five, Aidan McGowan. Number six is Luke O'Brien. He's their captain. He's their talisman. Ball is knocked down here. We'll come back to the team lineup now in a minute, and we just see the ball. It looks like it's going to fizzle out there, and it does. Number six, as we were saying, is Luke O'Brien, the captain of Tower Hill. Number seven is Nathan Carter. Number eight, Nathan Carpenter, as opposed to Nathan Carter, the singer. Number eight is Paul Sutton. Number nine is Hayden Delaney. Number 10, Paddy Downey. And number 11, and so far the hero with his two goals, is Jojo Salmon. So there's the lineups, and if there's any more changes to come, we'll keep you appraised of those. So Tower Hill launch an attack. The ball is down to Hayden Delaney. A good 50-50 there, and the referee actually given a free kick though for that one. He deemed the challenge by the Burtown number four, Ray Cordial, as being illegal. He has given the free kick to Tower Hill in a very, very attacking position. We can see now that number four, Jack Fennell, he was the really big, strong, imposing centre half, launching himself forward for Tower Hill. He is undoubtedly going to be the target man when this ball is kicked across from Nathan Carpenter, the Tower Hill number seven. Two-man Burr wall as they attack the town end of the goal. He strikes the ball, looking for Jack, too high for Jack, and cleared by Burr. Vital touch by one of the Burtown players to get the ball out there. And good tackle then from Hayden Doherty, the centre half, or the centre forward, for showing his defensive prowess there in terms of that tackle. He did very, very well to snuff out that Burr attack. So Burr start to build again. Neither team has really got going in the second half yet. Burr are really need to get back into this game if they're going to make a game of it. Tower Hill are quite happy the way things are proceeding. So a misplaced pass there from Nicky Malloy. He's trying to recover. Good to Paddy Downey is on the ball now. Good skillful player. He knocks, finds Nathan Carpenter back to Paddy Downey down the line. Really good intelligent play from Tower Hill there as Paddy stumbles, unfortunately for Paddy, and the ball ends up going out wide. So it's a goal kick for Bortown, but good play there between Paddy Downey and Nathan Carpenter from Tower Hill. Ball from the outside of the foot, misplaced pass by the Bortown player, but Burr win possession of the ball. It's now with their captain, Paul Egan. It looks up, a ball over the top to Nicky Malloy. A good challenge from Nathan or Jack Fennell. That was a brilliant, brilliant tackle from Jack Fennell at the back there, snuffing out that challenge, and the ball is out, and it will resume with a throw into Burr Town. So Burr Town now in an attacking position from this throw-in. Ball is back to the captain, Paul Egan. So Paul is looking around him. He's looking for a... knocks it back to his number three, Keith McAvoy. His shot is half blocked down. So Craig Short is on the ball now. Craig, very good experienced player, but that's going to be cleared by Tower Hill and added to by Paddy Downey, and now with Nathan Malloy. And then good interception there from Paul Egan as he knocks it back to the goalkeeper, the Burr Town goalkeeper. And Burr start to build. Declan Cahan is on the ball. He's looking up. He's looking to see can he hit this one long. Good long soul-searching ball. Great ball across. Oh, just miscontrol there by Nathan Williams, but he has found the ball and he's back to Keith McAvoy. Keith knocks the ball inside now. It's good football from Burr at the moment into Paul Egan, and Paul Egan goes down and has won the free kick from referee deemed a foul there from Martin Hillard. And is this a chop? This is again an opportunity from Burr, 24 yards out possibly from goals. And again, we're going to have to wait and see. The big men are up from the back. Raid Cordial has actually come back up. Declan Cahill has come up. It is slightly into the wind. The wind is downfield but cross as well. It has maybe lessened a little bit in the second half, but nonetheless, it's hard to know. Is this going to be a strike on goal by Craig Short? Is he going to chip it in? Or the big man there just as a decoy? Referee is getting it ready. Straight Craig Short is looking, he's going to strike it. He's going to go low and he's going to go hard, but it's well snuffed out by the wall. Paul Egan knocks it out wide, finds his man, who is Keith McAvoy, knocks the ball inside to Craig Short. He has the ball, he's knocking it across, he pulls it back, and a great interception there again. And the ball fizzes out, and it's gone to Nicky Malloy. He can't get under control. How did he do that? And he managed to squeeze it and hit the post, and it goes out wide. Really, that was great centre-forward play there by Nicky Malloy. Out of nowhere, he managed to squeeze himself and find a bit of space. He managed to get a shot on goal, and I think the goalkeeper parried it off the post and out wide. So it's a corner kick for Burr Town. Almost an opportunity for Burr there to get back in the game. Whoever gets the next goal, it's going to be vital, I think, because I don't think it'll be very hard for Burr to get back. The corner kick comes back to Paul Egan. A dangerous looking ball in, but too long, too high, and the ball has gone out wide. So time to take a breath again as both teams get their shape back, get themselves back together. That was certainly Burr's probably nearest opportunity in the second half, certainly so far. In the first half, a couple of strikes from Craig Short in the game. They were, I suppose, the real only opportunities that Burr had in the match. That ball from their centre-forward there, Nicky Malloy, that was the closest they've come to score. But of course, Tower Hill lead this match by 2-0, courtesy of 2 goals from Jojo Salmon. Good win in the ball. So the ball here now with the Burr Town number 11. He's jinking around. He's looking around. He hasn't sold any dummy. And it's out to Craig Short. And Craig Short actually shot high and wide. But again, I suppose that from the Burr perspective, they're going to be glad. They've created a couple of opportunities in the last couple of minutes. And they'll be kind of at least happy with that. So it's... eight minutes gone in the second half of the match. Ball has been retrieved. And certainly I don't think the Tower Hill goalkeeper Richard Downey is not going to be in any rush to see this ball back in play. 10 minutes gone in the second half so far. Ball is back with Jack Fennell. He's going to get that ball long, and he does. It's long and it's hard. It's back to Ray Corn. Paul Egan holds the ball and he has it, knocks it out wide to Nicky McAvoy. To Keith McAvoy. Keith now has the ball to Ray, back to Paul Hogan, back to Declan Cahill. So good play from Burr to hold on possession, out to Declan Cahill. Jojo Salmon coming into press. So Tower Hill certainly not pressing Burr when they get the ball, not trying to disrupt their play, trying to disrupt the pattern. But Burr find themselves a little bit of space, and the ball is then just kicked out harmlessly wide by Ray Cordell. It's one of those days when things just aren't going right for Burr, and when you're under pressure, you're two goals down and you're trying to force things to happen, sometimes things like this happen. Things just don't go your way because you're forcing things, and in a normal game, things that would happen very quickly. Good interception there from Keith McElvoy, just in front of us here, as Tower Hill looks to start with a throw in. Ball is down the line, and it's a good throw down the line. It's down with it fizzed across there. I thought Jojo Samu was going to get on that ball, but good play there. Hayden Delaney from a throw in latched onto the ball, fizzed the ball across the box. Jojo Salmon was sniffing around for which would be a hat trick for Jojo, because his two goals are what separates the teams at the moment. Tower Hill 2, Burtown 0. Jojo Salmon's two goals come in the 19th and the 23rd minute. Long ball over the top. It's a race, and the Burtown goalkeeper won that foot race. But Burr certainly have upped the ante in the last few moments. They know they have to throw a little bit of caution to the wind now at this stage, because they're two goals down and there is 12 minutes gone in the second half. Good headed win there from Declan Cahill. Goalkeeper is going to pick it up. He's going to look around. He's going to give it long. He has to give it long. He finds this man out to the side. And there it's with Keith McAvoy. So he passes the ball up the line to his number 11. Good footwork there from the number 11 to get himself a little bit of space. A little bit of a 1-2. Almost in. Good shot. Oh, just over. Just over. That was a corner ball. Super bit of football from Burr there. Nathan Williams exploded into life there. Some great football there. Some great link-up play. And it ended up with a fizzing shot just coming over. And the goalkeeper, Burtown goalkeeper, or the Tower Hill goalkeeper, Richard Downey, just managed to get a fingertip to it and push the ball over the bar. So Burr certainly on the hunt. They've got themselves back into this game in terms of creating more chances. First half, they didn't create this many chances. They've hit the post. They've had a really good shot. Corners coming across now. Good, really, really good headed clearance by Martin Heller there to relieve the pressure for his team as Burr look to build the play. They know they have to get something from this game, and they have to try and get themselves back into the game as time ebbs away. 13 minutes gone in the second half of the match. The Paul Egan, the captain, looks at the play. He's leaving it with Craig Short, but Craig is looking around. He's looking. A good ball in over the top. Has he found his man? He has, but it's offside. It was the substitute he found, Stephen Hanrahan, but unfortunately Stephen had managed to stray offside. So Tower Hill will get the opportunity to clear. So here we are. It's the 1920 John Farrell Combined Counties Cup Final live from Conor Davis Park in Mount Mellick, with Stryker Online. Some great games of football over the last few weeks from Stryker Online, including yesterday's FEA Junior Cup Final, which was won on a scoreline of 1-0. Fairview Rangers beating Usher Celtic in the final of that match. So ball launched long there from Burr, taken down by Declan Cahill, passed out to Charlie Healy, and Charlie then manages to doesn't link up very well with Dean Cahill, and the ball ends up being going out for a throw to Tower Hill. And Tower Hill will be absolutely delighted because they're not under pressure. They've got a 2-goal lead. They don't have to make anything happen. They just have to keep closing the space down. Don't let Burr build up any patterns of play or any rhythm. Jojo Salmon, who is causing all sorts of problems over there. And again, that's just illustrated. He's big, and he's a big, strong player, as is Hayden Delaney, the two front men from Tower Hill, certainly given the Burr defence a horrid time so far. You can see there Jojo's on the ball again. He holds it up and he just does the simple thing, gives it to Martin Hillard, but it breaks down. And now Craig Short, very quickly, he looks up and he tries to release Nathan William, but unfortunately the ball favoured fortunately for Tower Hill, it didn't favour Nathan William, so he didn't get a chance. But little passage of pay, he fizzed the shot over the bar, and it just showed there is a danger element to his game. Good young footballer, great future ahead of him. That's young Nathan Williams from Burtown, the Burtown number 11. So here we are, Burr building from the back again. So we've got Dean Cahill, he's looking around, he's looking to see can he find somebody. It's a run in from the number 13 from Burr. He ran down the line, that was Stephen Hanrahan, but it was intercepted by number 3, Mark Brennan. The Tower Hill defence really are coping very well with all that's been thrown at them so far. Burtown did hit the post about 4 minutes into the second half of the match. Nicky Malloy, from a scrambled effort, hit the post. We had a chance from Nathan Williams, but that's really been all that's been happening. A shot coming up here, Greg Short. He couldn't get his ball his foot wrapped around it very well. And that's a foul there for Joe Salmon. And referee allows it to kick quickly, and then he brings the free back. I thought he was going to allow it to play on quickly there, but he didn't. He brought it back for the original infringement. So it's now Tower Hill 2, Burr Town 0, and there is about 16 minutes gone in the second half of the match. So it's certainly Tower Hill certainly are in a commanding position at this moment in time. They're not taking it for granted yet. They have a long way to go. They'll know that they can't let Burr into this game. That's a big long relieving clearance from Jack Fennell. Goalkeeper Kim spilt the ball. Could have been a bit of a disaster, but unfortunately, or fortunately for him, he managed to recover at the second attempt. That could have been a disaster, but he did recover well. So well done to the Burr Town goalkeeper. And here we go. Along from the clearance, ball came off Stephen Hanrahan, and play will resume with the Tower Hill throw in. Ball down the line. It's to Jojo Salmon, that man again. He's causing all sorts of problems. And then deemed to have fouled Stephen Hanrahan. Referee, sharp blow on the wrist. He wants to have a word with somebody. He's not happy. Somebody is wants to have a discussion with Leslie. Leslie talking to two players at the moment there. That's Luke O'Brien, the captain from Tower Hill, and number seven for Burr, Dean Cahill. So that sorted out. We'll replay. Burr going to launch this ball forward. The big men are up from the back, Ray Cordial and Declan Cahill. They're going to hope to get onto this. It needs a good delivery, and it is a good delivery from Paul Egan. It's held up a little bit in the wind, and it does favour the... Oh, yes, a good tackle there from the Burr Town man. And the ball breaks out, but Joe Salmon again is on the ball. He's holding the ball up very well for his team. He knocks the ball into the corner to Hayden Delaney. He's not in any position. He's under pressure. He holds it up very well. Great target play from Hayden Delaney. Knocks the ball back now, and the ball is coming. He's caught. Nicky Malloy almost intercepted that ball for Burr Town. And it's the number five for Burr who knocks that ball forward. It was a good ball over the top from Aidan McGovern. And Charlie Healy, the fullback, had no choice. He had to put his head on it, and he managed to knock it out for a corner. So there's always going to be danger from these set pieces. You've got a big man like Jack Fennell coming forward, and he really is a handful. He'll be matched up by Declan Cahill, I'm sure, as they come forward. Luke O'Brien, the captain, he's also forward. Tower Hill not taking too many chances, though, keeping three men back. They're sitting on a 2-0 scoreline, a 2-0 lead. And the ball was won by Hayden Delaney, but referee said he was pushing, and he gives a free kick out. So we have Conor Hogan now. Conor looking round. He's urgently looking to see can he get this game to start. So Craig Short is on the ball. He's holding it up. He's putting the head down, and he knocks it backwards. So we have an injury here. And it was just innocuous. When he checked, he seems to have pulled a muscle. I think it could be a little bit of cramp. We did mention at the start of the match about the heat today, about the need to take fluids on. It is a very, very warm day. There is a breeze, but it's quite hot down the pitch side here. It must be 21, 22 degrees down by the pitch here. So it's quite understandable how, you know, you have a bit of cramping at this stage. Hayden Delaney looks for a little bit of attention. He's getting his attention. Hopefully he'll be able to continue. He's having a great game for his team, and he's doing very well. All the players at this stage trying to take a little bit of water on board, and the referee is just having a word there with the sideline. He's going to knock the ball back to Burr because they were good enough to knock the ball out. So game is on now. Game is back in play, and it looks like Hayden Delaney is getting a bit of a rub here. Temporarily Tower Hill down to 10 men. As they move forward, Ray Cordial. Ray finds Craig Short, a little bit of 1-2 play. He's checked inside, looking for some options, but there's so many Tower Hill players back, it's very hard to find space. He tries a 1-2 with Nicky Malloy, but there's so many bodies there forward at this stage from... it's so hard to find the space for the Burr Town lads as we have a substitution coming up here. Hayden Delaney, unfortunately, unable to continue. And we've got Emka Atta, who has now joined the pitch for Tower Hill. So if he going straight swap up front, it looks like Paddy Downey will race onto this one. Paddy has intercepted that ball. He's done very well. He tried to fight Jojo Salmon. Jojo didn't control it, but he found the man with the ball. Aidan McGovern has the ball, checks inside, he gives it to Jack Fennell, and Jack does what he does best, clears his lines. He's having a real good game at the back for Tower Hill, is Jack Fennell. So here we go, it's Paul Egan now is on the ball. He looks up and he finds Aidan Cahill. The ball is knocked inside, almost through to the Bortown number six, but it was snuffed out. But Tower Hill have possession of the ball now in the midfield. First time ball from Luke O'Brien. Idea was good. He thought he'd catch the Burr team a little bit flat, but good thinking, but just poor enough execution. So here we have Tower Hill, and it's snuffed out again, once again here by Ray Cordial. Knocks Burr looking around. Burr continue to find space, trying to find their men. They're knocking the ball around, they're looking around, but they really need to try and get some penetration. At the start of the first half, they had a couple of opportunities. They had a ball off the post, Nicky Malloy, and we had a Nathan Williams shot that fizzed over. But you can see Tower Hill now are packing their defence and they're conceding ground, but they don't really mind, because the pressure is on Bortown. It's not on. The pressure is on Bortown. It's not on Tower Hill. It's Tower Hill Rovers 2 and it's Bortown 0. And it's a very, very intriguing contest, and there is 23 minutes gone in the second half of this match. Anyone joining the match, any of our viewers, you're very, very welcome. It's Striker Online, and the referee has deemed it's time for a water break. So anybody joining online, it's the County's Cup final 2019-2020. 23 minutes gone in the second half. Tower Hill Rovers from Division 1, Laois-based team, playing in their biggest game ever in their history. Lead this match by 2-0 against the favourites, the newly crowned senior division champions, Bortown, seeking their fourth County's Cup final. So it is it's very, very tight, it's very, very tense. Those two early goals in the game came courtesy of Jojo Salmon, 19th minute for his first goal, and the second goal was in the 23rd minute. So we're going to resume play. Referee did give the water break there, and good to see common sense being applied, because it is very, very warm, it's very, very hot, and nice opportunity for the players to get fluids on board as this match now starts to go into its final third. It really is tight, it's tense. The favourites, Bortown, are probing, they're knocking the ball around, but they're not really penetrating in the final third. In the second half of the match, they did have one ball, but that hit the post. Nicky Malloy's effort scrambled clear, went out for a corner, and then a few moments later, in a little bit of a purple patch, Nathan Williams, at number 11, he had a shot fizzed over. Good save from Richard Downey in the Tower Hill goals. And really, since then, Burr haven't really created a whole lot. It's hard to see if they need something to happen to get themselves back in the match. Tower Hill quite content to keep the game plan. Their game plan is working very, very well so far. Jojo Salmon having a great game. Great ball inside. Is it number 7? He's free. And he missed it. He absolutely missed it, which was really, really... If that goal had gone in, it was actually a game set match. Nathan Carpenter missed an absolute... a sitter, I suppose you could say. He was clean on goal. He's got the opportunity here now. Bad mistake. And now we have referee said... And a little bit of controversy here. Referee saying nothing wrong, so we play on. So it's now the Bortown keeper, and now Paddy Downey went in, and the referee has actually, so the number 7 for Tower Hill is down injured. Nathan Carpenter, just moments after he spurned an opportunity, a great opportunity to put his team 3-0 up after a great through ball from Jojo Salmon. It's 25 minutes gone in the second half, so, and we can see now that Nathan Carpenter is up off his feet and he's back fit to resume. They've already lost one player through injury. Hayden Delaney has been replaced through a pulled muscle of some description by Emka Ataka, who is the number 15 for Tower Hill. He's on instead of him. So the ball is now with Bortown. Ray Cordial, he knocks it across to Declan Cahill. Declan has the ball. He's looking round. He's looking long. Good ball in. Can he find somebody? He can. He finds Good ball inside the back, a little ball underneath. And is this the Burr Town number seven in? Yes, great save, absolutely magnificent save. Great football from Burr, absolutely great football from Burr. Dean Cahill, great link up play. A little bit of a back heel from Craig Short. Declan Cahan still had a bit of work to do, but got himself clear, got the shot. It wasn't a great shot, it was weak, but nonetheless Richard Downey stood up very, very, very strong and very large, made the angle tight and saved the resulting shot from Dean Cahill. So that's the third opportunity, I suppose, we'd have to say in the second half that Dean Cahill has had, or not Dean himself but Burr Town have had, to try and get back in the game. And they still haven't managed to break, managed to find the breakthrough. So here we go, Burr building out from the back, and Nicky Malloy has found the ball, but he's dispossessed, coming deeper and deeper. You really don't want your centre forward coming this far forward at this stage of the game. Martin Hillard doing very well there, driving forward, taking a shot. It's weak enough, it will be found by the keeper from Burr. He's not going to hang around with it, he's looking for someone to find, he wants to get it out quickly, but he's delayed. Ball has now been launched forward and won by Tower Hill, back down again. Now it's with Charlie Healy, he knocks up, and it's with Paul Egan. Paul looks around and he finds Ray Cardle as Burr build yet another phase of attack and another possession. So Nathan Williams, and he's chopped down there from behind by number two, James Furlong. He won't mind. It's not exactly a goal scoring opportunity from here. Craig Short is going to place it. The big men are going to go forward. You see Declan Cahill, he's jogging forward. Charlie Healy, he's been left behind to mind the house, as the Burr probe push more bodies forward now to try and get back in this match. So good in-swinging ball, but it doesn't find anybody. It does find the head of number four, Jack Fennell. He deflected it out for a corner kick. So play will resume with a corner kick for Burr Town. 28 minutes gone in the second half of this match. It's Tower Hill 2, Burr Town 0. Can Burr find a way? It's a corner kick, in-swinging kick. Clash of bodies, up the go, and the goalkeeper from Tower Hill races out to collect the ball as it's spilt from an ensuing group of bodies. He looks up, he tries to find his number seven here, Nathan Carpenter. MCAT has the ball, he knocks it 1-2, but too far wide, and he missed it. Jojo Salmon is backing up his players though. He has the ball. Jojo is really having a good game today. Knocks the ball across, but it's cleared by Charlie Healy to the Burr Town number seven, Dean Cahill. Dean tries to get the ball clear. It's half blocked down and it's half cleared. Tower Hill in possession with the ball again, knocking the ball. Little triangular play. They're doing very well. They're holding the ball up well. They are certainly going well at this stage. So Martin Hallard has the ball. It chips it across, but too high, too wide, and spurns the opportunity to get his team further ahead, or create a chance. It was good approach work. Again, Jojo Salmon, he's the guy that, you know, seems to be doing all the damage. Nathan Hayden Delaney has gone off. We have a substitution here now coming up. It's number 17 for Shane Brophy, replacing the Luke O'Brien. The captain from Tower Hill is coming off, and fair to say that Luke has done a sterling job for his team. He has given everything, and you can see there it's so warm, it's so hot, trying to freshen things up and trying, you know, put fresh legs on the pitch. So let's just see how the last 15 minutes of this match pans out now. Drive and run by Paul Egan, but dispossessed. Ball is back up, and Attack got his ball, and it's picked up by the number seven, his first touch. He wins possession, finds his Paddy Downey, who knocks the ball out to Jojo Salmon. Jojo, lazy, languid style, finds Paddy Downey in the return ball, knocks it back. Good pull back, and it's off the ball, it's off the cross pass, and nearly in and off the arm. And what about that? It was very, very nearly a 3-0 lead for Tower Hill. Super play between Jojo Salmon and number 10, Paddy Downey. There, great link-up play. The ball was cut back from Paddy Downey. It was struck by number 17. The substitute has just been on, Shane Brophy, and that could have been 3-0. So really now at this stage, Tower Hill are creating chances as well as defending well. So it's the Burr are really under pressure to get themselves back in this game now. Craig Short, driving run. He's looking for something to happen. He's looking for players to move. He checks back inside. It's good football by him. He takes the shot, but it's charged down. It would have been very speculative there. So we now have Emke Adak, who's very much on his own. He steps by Declan Cahill finds Martin Hillard. He puts the ball into the corner, and this is good football. Good, intelligent football from Tower Hill. They're holding the ball up. They're not in a rush. They know that they're leading the match by 2-0, but they give away possession easily in the end. But it has been retained and won back by Tower Hill, so no harm done. So here we have Paddy Downey, who's playing very, very well, into Shane Brophy. Shane takes a shot, a speculative shot. He was 30 yards out. It would have been really good to have beaten the Burrtown keeper, Conor Hogan, from there. But nonetheless, it's a shot, I suppose, and there's a change coming up here now for Burrtown. So here we have number 14 for Burr going on is Ronan Bergen. Ronan, part of the Burr under 17 squad, so it just goes to show the profile, age profile of some of the Burr players. Some great young talent coming through, and it's Ray Cordial who's been replaced. So it's probably Burr going to go between three at the back, I would say, at this stage. They really have to throw caution to the wind, and I suppose it's a sensible approach by Shane Corby. Just to do a time check, if I can actually see it here, it's 32 minutes gone in the second half of the match. It's Tower Hill Rovers who lead on a 2-0 scoreline. So Burr tried to move out and attack, but at this stage Tower Hill are fighting tigerishly for everything, and it's paying dividends. And so Evgen Afghan passes the ball into Paddy Downey. He knocks the ball across, so almost finds Shane Brophy, the substitute. So game is getting very stretched now. Burr, long ball over the top to Nathan Williams. So Nathan has the ball, so Nathan checks inside and wins his team a throw. So James Furlan having a very good game on Nathan Williams, because he is one of the danger men on the Burr team. He's going okay, but he's having a good game nonetheless. James Furlong is James is now suffering from a little bit of cramp, so we have another injury here to the Tower Hill player. Busy physio today for Tower Hill as he makes his way to go in. Can't see who's actually injured at the moment. It looks like Nathan Carpenter it is for Tower Hill, who's looking for a little bit of injury. 33 minutes gone in the second half. Is there a way for Burrtown back into this match? Is the fairy tale for a team from Division 1, it hasn't happened for a while, going to win the County's Cup? Tower Hill, who have never won the County's Cup before, against three times winner Burrtown, the lead on the 2-0 scoreline. And just to remind anyone who's listening in or looking in online, those two goals came in the first half. Jojo Salmon scored the two goals. The 19th minute was the first goal, and the 23rd minute was the second goal. So substitution actually is ensuing as a result of the injury. Unfortunately, it looks like Nathan Carpenter is unable to continue, and it's the substitute number 14 who is going on there, who is Gary Rowe. So Gary just itching to get in. Who wouldn't? It's the County's Cup final. Every player wants to play in the County's Cup final in the CCFL. It's a prestigious competition. It's been played for many, many years, and it's absolutely a wonderful occasion. And today has been a really good, intense game of football. Two really good teams playing good football, and in a good sport game of football. So first touch for the Burrtown player Stephen Bergen, and back to Paul Egan. He juggles around with the ball. He tries to find Declan Cahill. Good, dangerous ball in. The goalkeeper actually gets up. Big goalkeeper. Safe hands. Collected that ball. He called. He took responsibility and he took it into his hand. And a very, very good save. And safe hands from Richard Downey. Launches the ball long, and it's over the top. So Jojo Salmon has the ball now. So we know what Jojo's going to do. He's going to hold it up, and he's just going to bring his players into it. Look at really superb play there. He finds the number 17, Shane Brophy, who loses possession. The ball is up now. It's gone to Martin Hillard. Martin knocks the ball inside. He finds Paddy Downey. Paddy is having another superb game of football as well. Into James Furling. James gives the ball away. It's back to Paul Egan. Declan. To Craig Short. Dick looks up, knocks the ball. He finds a wide man there. He's looking for it. It's Dean Cahill. He's found Dean. Dean trying to make the ball. It's not actually. It's the substitute for Burr. It's their first substitute in the match. It was the number 13 who actually had the ball there. That was Stephen Hanrahan. But Stephen lost possession of the ball, and now we have the ball has just fizzled out there for a throw into Burr, and we yet have another injury to a Tower Hill player. It looks like number 12, Martin Hillard, it looks like he's injured. And the referee has called in, once again he has called in the physio to give some attention. 36 minutes gone in the second half of the match. There is about 9 minutes to go. Can Burr find a way back into this match? It really is going to be very, very hard to see them getting themselves back into the match. Players taking a chance to get water on board. Just looking at the roll of honour for the County's Cup. Three wins for Bourtown, 91, 97, 1997 and 2018. Six wins for Clara Town. Three wins for Mullick United, who are the home team here. Two wins for Mullingar Athletic, four for Willow Park, and the leaders on the County's Cup Roll of Honour, Killaville United, with eight titles starting in 91 with their last title in 2005. Who's going to win? It's going to be a new name of Tower Hill on the County's Cup. 8 minutes to go in the match. At this moment in time, it looks very much that like that way. Bourne trying their utmost to get back into the game, but Tower Hill are doing very, very well. They're snuffing out the opportunities. Referee says handball, and Jojo looks and he said, "It hit my head, ref." Referee said, "No, sorry, Jojo, not having that. It's actually going to," and he spotted the foul and he gave the infringement. So Bourne get a chance to launch the ball forward. And they do so, and it's they pushed again. Once again, Declan Cahill, their big man, has gone up to the back. Paul Egan, their captain, is going to take the free kick. Every player from, except the Bourtown goalkeeper, now in the Bourne half or the Tower Hill half of the pitch. It goes, it's headed towards Declan Cahill. He jumps up, he wins the ball, but it's going to fizzle out. It's going to be cleared by number two, James Furlong, for Tower Hill, and it falls out here. Bourne does very well to keep the ball in play there. It falls, Paul Egan fizzes the ball across. They're looking for offside. The offside flag has not been given, but the ball beats the substitute, Nate Stephen Hanrahan, unfortunately for Bourne Town. But Tower Hill be quite happy with that. There is not much time left now in the match. 37 minutes, 38 minutes almost gone in the second half of this match. There will be stoppage time. There will be time on. There has been a couple of physio visits to the pitch, but that's not going to worry the Tower Hill fellas. Bourne have to find an answer, and they have to find an answer soon. I can't see it. Everything that happens is happening for them today. It doesn't seem they're not getting any luck, but Tower Hill have worked a master plan out. They're quite happy to give away the possession, but they're two front players, and even since the departure of Hayden Doherty with their new strike force, Aiton attack, they're still doing a lot of good work up front for Tower Hill and putting pressure on the Bourne back line. So here we are, we're going to resume play with a throw-in. It goes back to the goalkeeper for Bourne. He's looking round, he's going to knock the ball out wide, and Bourne are going to start. Bourne will continuously start to build from the way they do at the back. They're trying to build up the pay, they're trying to move through the phases, but it's very hard. It's very hard for them to find a space in behind. So the ball has gone long, it's gone over the top. Craig Short goes chasing after the ball. He doesn't get there. It's cleared by Mark Brennan. He goes out for a throw-in, but he's happy. He's cleared his lines and he's snuffed out the danger for now. Bourne Town looking round now at this stage, looking for a man. And it goes to Ronan Bergen. Ronan can't keep it under control, but it breaks back to Craig Short. He looks inside, a little chip inside, but it's straight into the hands of Richard Downey, the goalkeeper from Tower Hill. He holds it up, and as you can see, Richard is in no hurry to release the ball. And he looks this side, he turns it. He doesn't quite get a good connection, but Jojo Salmon wins the header, but it only finds a Bourne Town player. Now it's out to Charlie Hurley. Charlie looks up. He almost puts through a good ball to his teammate, but it's found by Tower Hill. Now the Tower Hill try to break away, so it's now with Nathan Williams. He's a good young footballer for Bourne Town. He finds a man out wide. Who does he find? It's the Bourne Town number 13, the substitute second half, Stephen Hanrahan. He makes a run. He's well marshalled though, very well marshalled by Mark Brennan though. And once again, Tower Hill clear the lines. Declan Cahill has the ball. He's looking up. He hits the ball. It's too hard. It's too long. And it's not going to trouble the Tower Hill offence on this stage. It was a good interception by Declan Cahill, but it's just an illustration that Bourne are having to force everything, hurry everything. And when you're two goals down and you're under pressure, things go against you as they do. But Tower Hill won't mind. It's Tower Hill 2, Bourne Town 0. And there is 40 minutes gone in the second half of the match. 5 minutes to go in this. Could there be a bit of history? Could there be a new name going on the County's Cup? At this stage, it's looking very, very likely. It really does look likely. And it looks like PJ Garland and Paul Cullen have done a great job in masterminding this victory for the Division 1 team from Port Leash. It could be a famous victory for them. 5 minutes to go. Bourne will not give up until the final whistle. But it is just, it's Tower Hill are just defending so well today. It's very, very hard to see the breakthrough. So the ball is knocked in wild. Out it comes to Nathan Williams. He does lovely footwork. In almost links up with Ronan Bergen. Snapshot from Craig Short. Great interception from Paul Egan there, because that ball was actually true. The Tower Hill player was true if that hadn't been intercepted. But Tower Hill have really done well themselves. Almost two great chances to go 3-0 up. One hitting the post, and the other one where their injured player number 7, Nathan Carpenter, missed an opportunity. But so it's been a really, really tight contest, and Tower Hill really, really doing very well. They really are struggling a little bit now. You can see they're out on their feet, but it is an extremely warm day. It must be 22 degrees. Ball is headed back, but harmlessly enough to the Borough goalkeeper Conor Hogan, knocks it out wide to Keith McAvoy. Keith's looking up, he's seen, can he find somebody, knocks the ball inside to Nicky Malloy, finds Paul Egan, Paul finds Declan Cahill. But this is all football that's been played in the wrong half of the pitch as far as Borough is concerned. Tower Hill won't really mind. They're giving up space, they're giving up possession, but when it comes to the final third, their defending is tigerish and they're not giving any opportunity to Borough lads. That's just a good example as their centre half Aidan McGovern clears the line. So here we have Borough again at the back. Here we have the slow build up, but again, as the ball builds up slowly at the back, Tower Hill just don't mind. They have a very, very solid defensive, really good tactical plan by Tower Hill today. So here we have Craig Short, one of the Borough experienced players. We talked about Craig. He's had a lot of the ball today, but not in the right areas of the field to do damage. So Craig's on the ball now and wins a throw-in for his player. So here we've got a new substitution coming up here, and it's Kevin Sheenan is taken. He's actually going to replace Martin Hillard. Martin Hillard has had a fantastic game, 38 years of age. He's had a wonderful game for his team today for Tower Hill, and it's very little left in this match now. 43 minutes gone in the second half, so at this stage it looks very much like the Tower Hill Rovers are going to put their names on the County's Cup. A little bit of history, new name going on the County's Cup. Borough have given their all, but Tower Hill have executed a master plan, and it's been a really, really good game of football. We've got 2 minutes left in the match plus stoppage time. There have been quite a number of injuries and quite a number of visits by the physio onto the pitch, so there will be injury time. Can Borough find a way back in? Is it too late? Free kick there, foul given away. Somebody dismaying in the background there about that free kick, because it was a soft free kick to give away, and Tower Hill will rue this opportunity if Borough manage to get in. So can't see the Borough Town player who's actually going to take this free kick, but he's looking up. It's going straight into the box. He's going to hope to find his big man Declan Cahill. It's hanging up in the wind. Goalkeeper's coming, gets his two hands and it gets it out, and he's down on the ground, but he won't really mind, because the ball cleared, and it's with Jojo Salmon. He's holding up the ball. Jojo does what he does best, holds the ball up, knocks the ball down the line, and it's fizzed in again. It's found Ronan Bergen, but he can't find a link man, and the ball is just thumped clear. And so we've got it with Imka at attack, and he has the ball. He finds Paddy Downey. Now Tower Hill breaking at space. Can he find a man? Can Paddy Downey find a man? He looks up. He's holding it up. He's doing a great job. He's going into the corner. He's doing the sensible thing, because he's wasting precious time. He's holding. He's using the precious time. He's holding it up. Borough have managed to wiggle the ball free, but it breaks out to Jojo. Jojo Salmon finds his man in the box. It's Imka Atka. He takes a shot and it hits the side netting. It hits the side netting, but snapshot there. Almost a chance. But it's frenetic stuff. The goalkeeper passes the ball out and almost finds... plays his team into trouble. We've got Craig Short. He was fouled there. That's one for Aidan McGovern. He's taken one for the team. It's a yellow card, but I think anyone who's played the game knows why those type of fouls are given away. It's as good as a shot on goal, because he had to do that. So the ball is coming in. Borough really pressing, searching. It's in. It's a header. It's in, but it's actually gone wide. Really unlucky, I think, there. I'm not sure who got their head on the ball. Can't see who it was. I think it could have been Nathan Williams. I think at this stage it doesn't really matter, because the ball has gone wide. It was a good ball in from Keith McAvoy. It did find one of his teammates, but the ball ended up being fizzed wide. So it's just one of those days for Borough. I don't think they could buy a bit of luck for themselves today. But that said, it goes in the context that Tower Hill Rovers executed a master plan. They were prepared to defend. They were prepared to break, hit Borough on the break, and two goals in the first half, in the 19th minute and the 23rd minute by Jojo Salmon, is what separates these teams. It's been a frenetic second half. Borough have had chances. Tower Hill have had chances. This game could have ended up second half. It could have ended up possibly 4-2 at this stage in terms of chances. But it's still 2-0. Is there a way back from Borough? I'm not sure what the referees is going to give in terms of additional time. There's 46 minutes on the clock now in the second half. So it's really down to the referee's discretion at this stage. Paul Egan is upended there. So it's now actually a free in for Burr. We're almost a minute and a half into injury time at this stage now. And one has got to think that the Tower Hill are going to have their names on the County's Cup tonight. Burr Town, the favourites. Newly crowned senior division winners. But the ball is fizzed in. It goes in. It finds Declan Cahill. It doesn't find Elliott. It's Jack Fennell who's had a towering game. And then the referee spots an infringement. And there's a big cry, a big shout from the Tower Hill bench because they feel that that's actually, that this is a very, very important free to win for the team. I'm not sure who won it. I know that the Tower Hill lads are pretty much out on their feet at this stage, but who can blame them? They put in a massive effort on behalf of their club. It's really, really exciting stuff for the club. Their two managers, we talked about them, PJ Garland and Paul Cullerton, really done a great job priming their team for the match today. James Furlong won that ball, knocked it down for it. It's the substitute. Number 14, Gary Rowe, is on the ball. He almost gets through on the ball, but he doesn't quite get there. And it's launched forward by Bird keeper, but it breaks out. And again, Tower Hill don't have possession. Ball is now with Nicky Malloy. He's looking around for a teammate, someone to find. Knocks it out to the substitute, Stephen Hanrahan. He puts the ball across. Nicky Malloy gets his head on it. I thought it hit the back of one at Tower Hill, but it didn't. It was just went out wide. So again, McAvoy or Tower Hill have cleared their line. So it's now 48 minutes. So I'd say at this stage there is very little left in the match. We've got a Burr Town injury down now at this stage. He's down, and it looks like Paul Egan, the Burr Town captain. He looks a bit winded. He wholehearted player, Paul. Tremendous player for his club. Took a bit of a knock, but it'll take more than a little knock to keep Paul from continuing to play because he's a wholehearted player and he's been a real driver behind his team. But Tower Hill on the cusp of a very, very famous victory. It's 48 and a half minutes on the clock. It's second half, it's the County's Cup final. It's Tower Hill 2, it's Burr Town 0. Is there a way back from Burr? Good ball over the top, but the goalkeeper from Richard Downey, who has had a very solid game for his team. He has made the vital saves when they were, particularly in the second half, when he made a fantastic fingertip save from Burr Town number 11, stinging shot. Nathan Williams, he really tested him, but the goalkeeper has been strong. He's been really good in the air, and he sniffed out every opportunity. So here we are. It's now, at this stage, 49 minutes on the clock. There's been 4 minutes of injury time. It's in the correct end of the field if you're a Tower Hill player. Ball is thrown down, it's over the line. Who does it find? Jojo Salmon is on it, that man again. But the ball goes out and it's actually a goal kick. It must be getting close now at this stage. It must be very close to completion. It's 49 minutes on it. So here we go. It's Tower Hill Rovers that are on the cusp of a very famous win. Burr will continue to do what they do best, build from the back. But it's the penetration. They really don't get the penetration up front because of the packed defence that Tower Hill have. So Nathan Williams has the ball, knocks the ball out, finds his man. Or does he find his man? Keith McAvoy. Ball is cleared and it goes down and it's now going to be a Tower Hill throw and they will be delighted with that because there can't be much left. There cannot be much left. In this game, it's the 19-20 John Farrell Combined Counties Cup Final with compliments of Striker Online. Great football, great games, and that ball is again fizzed out. It's off a Burr Town player. He couldn't keep it in play, so we now have a throw in for Tower Hill. Two balls in front of us, two of the referee have spoiled for choice at the moment. So Davy Bryant, the assistant there, takes one of them back. Ball is down. 2 minutes left, they're saying here. I'm not sure, we don't know how long the referee is. It's 50 minutes played on the clock, but there has been a number of injuries, so obviously there has been almost a mistake by Declan Cahill there as he knocked the ball forward. So here we go, Paul Egan, he has to launch the ball forward. He finds Nicky Malloy, who finds Declan Cahill. He chips the ball in over the top. Is it too far? It's too far, it's too hard. And Richard Downey is going to hold that ball up, and there it is. That's the final whistle. It's all over. Tower Hill Rovers have done almost the impossible. I won't say it's the impossible because it's a big shock. They beat the Burr Town favourites. It's been a fantastic game of football. as it was finished 2-0 Tower Hill Rovers. Two goals in the first half. Jojo Salmon, 19th minute with the first goal, 23rd minute with the second goal. A fantastic game of football. Two really good teams played in a very sporting venue. And once again, before we hand over, we'll just say thanks to Striker Online for bringing this live game. It's a wonderful platform to see grassroots football being streamed across the country, across the Ireland. We hope you've enjoyed the commentary today. We hope you've enjoyed the match. We certainly have enjoyed it. It's history. Tower Hill Rovers with their name on the County's Cup for the very first time. So well done. And signing off from a sunny Conor Davis Park, this is Chris Hand on behalf of Striker Online.
Further presentation before the main event. Man of the match, Jack Fennell. Any further ado, I'd ask Tower Hill Rovers captain to come forward and accept the Evan. County's Cup.
This is a feeling that we wanted for the last, I don't know how long. I'm playing 15 to 20 years with a lot of the lads there. And we've never even got to the final, never got very near. So it's just incredible just to think that we did it this year, especially at the, I don't know if anyone knows, at the start of the year, it was touch and go whether we actually go ahead or not. We didn't have enough players. We had 10, 12 at training. It wasn't good enough for a squad. We had no manager either. And I think it was the weekend before the season was supposed to start. We got together, manager team of PJ Garland and Paul Cullerton, who kept it all together, and it was up to them really that got going at the start. So this is, well, these are two people as far, but Paul and PJ, thanks a million, it's unbelievable. And especially, I know if the rumours are true, he's, he always says he's quitting every year, but PJ, this is supposed to be your last year. If it is, I hope this was the best year you had in football, because you deserve it. And the same, it's just when we came back from the lockdown, the same story again, very low in numbers, and just the same core lads, we kept going training. We fell apart in the league, let's be honest about it. We were here the other night, we lost 6-0. What a difference a few days makes. I want to thank the last person, is our chairman, Paddy Keller, who started this club in 2012. Paddy's been manager, he's now our chairman, and he's just down, he's down every match he can. And I think this is the main one, this is for you, Paddy. I'd also like to say thanks a million to Burr for the game. He won the league the other day, I'm delighted for you. Just unlucky on the day, we were due a good game in the cup final. We left it all behind us over the years. And we'd just like a round of applause for Burr. Well done your season, guys. Thanks a million. Right, the last thing I'll say, I don't know what the pub situation is tonight, but I'm sure we'll find somewhere that you don't have to get a meal for anyway. So thanks everyone, thanks to CCFL, the referees, the whole lot. Thanks a million to Mount Mellick for the pitch, and thanks very much. Over and out.
Come on! And bad mistakes, I've made a few. I've had my shoes and kicked in my face, but I've come through. And I need to go
Listen, we're here. It's the aftermath of the 1920 John Farrell Combined Counties Cup final. Paddy, can you believe it?
No, Chris, it's unbelievable. To come how far we've come in 8 short years. Started out in 2012. Struggled the last couple of years to get numbers in, and the big change this year has been the two boys coming in, PJ and Paul. They can take a lot of credit for this today. But plus a lot of the players, that man's been there since the first game we ever played in 2012. and he's been a stalwart ever since, and he deserves this, and all those lads deserve this here today.
Jack Fennell being man of the match today. Jack, you had a massive game at the back, but listen, I just want to talk a little bit, I suppose. How did you plan today? Like, I mean, what was the plan going into the game? Because Burr were the favourites, they were just after winning the senior division. You've had a long old year yourselves, but what was the plan?
I think we've played a few big games recently, and what we found is we had slow starts, and we just put a lot of focus into the first 20 minutes, being strong, being compact, sticking together, and having a bit of shape about us. And we got lucky with a couple of goals, maybe a couple of ball over the top or whatever, but when we had something to hang on to, we weren't going to let it go too handy. And we've had our ups and downs this year, but one thing to do, we're very close as a team, a lot of friends in it, so you find when we've something to battle for, we die on our shields for it, like, you know. So it was just to work hard, try out work for. We knew they were going to be a good team, have a lot of the ball. So we're going to seed space and just maybe hit them on the counter-attack, and look, it worked out for us today.
Yeah, I noticed that pattern from the game. You're quite happy to let Burr have the ball in their half of the field, knock the ball around. You knew that's what Burr were good at doing. But the two guys up front, you know, Jojo and... they were really very good, very effective, and the major chances count. But was that was the plan all along? So just to concede the space and then to hit on the counter.
Yeah, well, the managers changed the formation today. They had been playing 4-4-2, and a couple of lads very, very, very unlucky to miss out today. But to change the formation, to put in a holding midfielder, and put two, unfortunately, Paul Sutton, who's been one of the players of the year, pulled up in the warm up, and but that was the plan, to get three into midfield to match them. But like, the boys put it in, like, with disappointing result Wednesday night. As Jack said, it was up and down all year. They had to change something, but we knew the quality was there. Like, we know on our day that we're as good as any team in this CCFL, but we just haven't had our day enough. But thankfully it happened today anyway.
And then back to yourself then, Jack. You know, you lost Paul in the warm-up, but what about Martin Hillard, 38 years of age? I mean, very good replacement to have.
I said to Hilly before the game, I love when you're playing in front of me, because you know what you're going to get. It's going to be 100% effort. And people kind of gloss over the fact when he's on the ball, he's a bloody good player. So we were lucky today, we had 18 players. When even you might have noticed with all the subs that come in, there was no drop-off in standard of effort and quality. So if we had that all year, we've a bit of a year of regrets with the league and all that, because we didn't have the numbers all year. But just goes to show, when we have a full squad, we can compete. And today was kind of a testament to that, with Hilly coming in and doing a job.
Okay, lads, listen, I'm going to let you go back to your celebrations. Congratulations, 2019-2020 County Cup winners. Well done, Tower Hill Rovers.
Thanks, lads.